Before welcoming the next speaker, I have a curiosity. Is there anyone which is in ISEC or was in ISEC before? The international organization? So you know the clap? There's a specific clap which ISEC does. You know it? No. It's the increasing tempo. You know it? Do you want to show it to the others as well? I think I wasn't in ISEC, so I don't know. Say it out loud. Yeah. We're going to do it together, but first understand how.
So, in the beginning, someone is starting to clap, and our goal is to do it synchronized. Mm-hmm. Yeah? And at the end, we'll have like all the people will clap together in the same rhythm or something like this.
Yeah.
Is this the thing?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, do you want to start?
Yeah.
Come on. Thank you. So our next speaker is going to be we're going to remain in the field of academia. Mr. Viktor Danishenko, which is a PhD lecturer and fellow editor of journalism research at Vilnius University, is going to speak about packet problem, direct political communication in social networks.
Okay. Good afternoon. Hello, survivors of afternoon of Friday. Nice to be here. So, from one point, I'm journalist, and how it was mentioned, it's no ex-journalist. It's like you are like an alcoholic. You are a journalist, and you are a journalist. So, from one point, I'm presenting Vilnius University, Faculty of Communication. From another, I'm still working like a journalist sometime, and I'm co-founder of InBaltic. It's a media initiative in social networks, in Facebook, and it's in Russian and part in Polish language. But today I will talk like a representative of my department. It's Department of Political Communication. And so yesterday at the evening we had a question, to be or not to be, of course to be. Yeah, but today is another question, to tag or not to tag. And tagging in social networks is part of our culture. It's part of our culture in social network. What it means? We know rules. We know ways how we could act or should act. And tagging persons in social network is part of this culture. And the question is how it could be used in political communication. Very simple answer is directly. So journalists telling stories, and I want also start from one story, it's selfish slide, yeah? One story. Today in Lithuania is quite many emigrants from Russia. In fact, these emigrants going to Lithuania and another states in Europe due to political reasons, mostly. Because, you know, Kremlin police, last year's Ukrainian case and so on and so on. And some people think that they could not live in Russia anymore. So some of these people choosing Lithuania. But it means that many of these people not asking of asylum, but just trying to get permission to live in Lithuania, doing business. And one such person, it's Yulia Bashinova, former journalist of Grani.ru, Russian liberal media outlet. She moves with family to Lithuania, They tried to make business. First of all, it was kindergarten for Russian-speaking kids. Now we have like an advertising agency, public relations agency. But problem was that the Lithuanian Department of Migration said, but we are not sure, but your business is real. So it's big question, do you will have this get prolonging of permission to live in Lithuania? It was very long story. We tried to, well, it's Julia and members of his family to like provide evidence that it's real business, it's everything in frames of law. But this story was very long. So Julia asked friends in Lithuania, just write letters, not public letters, but letters to Department of Migration to like show that they are not criminals, they really love Lithuania and want to stay in Lithuania. One of these persons, which was asked to write letters, I am one of these persons, so I wrote letter. And also I published story how I wrote letter in a newspaper that was Genius. It's oldest Lithuanian newspaper, not most popular, but a good one. So I have a poem in this newspaper. So I wrote story, but you know, to write story and to publish story is not enough, because it's very important who are readers of this story. And for me it was very important to people who could make a decision or could maybe manage situation or could talk about situation in a much powerful voice. They be readers of the story. So I tag all persons I know directly, politicians, people who working in political public relations, also advisor of Prime Minister, former journalist of 15 Minutes, and what's this result? In fact, first of all, I get many comments from these persons, and comments was very interesting, because comments was I think that it's problem in Department of Migration. No, I write that it's totally mess in Department of Migration. It's not only problem. So finally, it's success story, not about my article. First of all, Julia and family of Julia, they get prolonging of permission to live in Lithuania. And I don't think that this, my article was this powerful thing which was guarantee of success of story. It was just very small step, because other politicians, other people also know about story and act. But it's like a prologue to question. What is communication in social network? Does it communication or imitation of communication? To try answer to this story, I made research. It's not scientific research, it was more journalistic research. First, what you should know, that in Lithuania, Facebook is the most powerful social network. In Lithuania, we have now approximately 3 million inhabitants. And a few years ago, by statistic, in Facebook was more than 1 million of accounts of Lithuanians. In fact, you could directly to communicate to one to big part of Lithuania, of Lithuanian people in Facebook. And I tried to look to this challenge, issue of direct political communication in social network as to fact of opportunities and threats. So, what it is? It's some aspects of political, direct political communication in social network. And you could see that positive aspects, we have more positive aspects than negative, for example. Political, with tagging politicians in social networks often are providing to improve political discussion, of course. Or, but it's natural to express dissatisfaction of some political decision to ask for help, yeah? And maybe to provide some political offers. Negative one, but it's very, very important. It's a negative aspect. It's for trolling, because if you could use it for trolling, and it's often happens. Talking about these opportunities, it's quite very important because it's direct communication without mediators, like a journalist, like a public relations officer, and so on. It's also two-way communication. It's important because it's like a dialogue between person and politician. Possibility of faster decision, if it's possible, of course. And last but not least, politicians feel the obligation to answer because it's like a public request. Friends of person and friends of politician saw, but it was a request. And if politician will not answer, it's, he not or she, well, it doesn't matter about this issue. So, friends, it could be too many requests, of course, because we are humans, yeah, and too many requests is a bad thing. Wrong candidates, because if you're asking a politician of local level, municipal level to act national problem, so it's not useful. Of course, social networks often are not for deep political discussions. Biggest problem, this is, troll under the bridge. Request not for discussion, but for trolling. And in Lithuania, we have a man, mayor of Vilnius, capital of Lithuania. He is Remigius Šimašius. And in Lithuanian language, it's a linguistic form for address. If you address another person in Lithuanian language, you should use some form, like in this case, it's Šimašiu. You ask, Šimašiu. So this Šimašiu, hashtag Šimašiu, became a meme, because Remigius Šimašius was quite active on Facebook. I want to show one quotation of my colleague Andrius Šuminas. He also member of Digital Communication Network, and I hope you will see him in other events. He, when we discussed this question about tagging, he mentioned that, yeah, in fact, in Ukraine we have a social, civic society, it's okay, but this communication in social networks is still not very useful, because but sometimes, on the other hand, Ukrainians communicating social networks reminds a kind of bullying and trolling. So, kind of evidence, because it's not scientific conclusions, but it could be very useful if, first of all, other people saw that you made a request and politicians have an obligation to answer, feel obligation to answer. Of course, topic should belong to area of responsibility of this politician. Yeah? And it should be a constructive communication, not trolling. So, unsuccessful trolling, hate speeches, so on. The results of my journalistic research I put to article who reads in Russian could find it in Baltic, of course. Yeah, it also will be one text in Lithuanian, in English, I don't know, maybe. So, thank you for attention.
Questions? Very good pen. And yes, questions. One question, actually. That was tricky with the laptop.
Yeah.
Good catch.
Good catch and good skills for sure. As well. What do you do if the targeted people do not answer?
In fact, nothing. But it's like a signal. It's like a signal, but it doesn't matter. Yeah. And for politician, for image of politician, it could be like kind of problem in some cases.
Yep. But do you track this? How many? If they actually respond to the issue that where you tag them, because if they don't, then yeah, it also might be that the topic is not, let's say, deep enough.
So here I most talk about possibilities. About theoretical approach to this problem, I think we could discuss about this issue because I have no like a direct answer to your question. In my case, in fact, all this personal case, all politicians or not only politicians, but people from political public relations, they answer and. So I not expect so many answers in comments, not in personal message, but it was not a fact of public discussion, it was in comments.
Thank you very much, Victor.
Thank you.